All Blacks facing the sun in the first half as Ruji Tamar gets the test match underway. And did he put it out on the full? No, he didn't. The All Blacks let it go, and the French immediately swing on to attack. And the first line-out of the game is just 5 metres from the All Black line. So let's try and pick up one or two of these players for you. Mark Session, number six, at the back of the line-out. Alan Kamenati just in front of him as Sean Fitzpatrick throws. Number four for New Zealand, Murray Pearce, went high. It's on the All Black side. Dean's waiting, and Dean's clears. And good line-out win for the All Blacks first up.
Well, I think New Zealand will consolidate a lot more in this test. I think you'll see Joe Stanley cutting back more, and also I think you'll find Jones will run off rucks and walls too. They'll set him up midfield.
Immediately, a short line-out called by the French. Number five, Jean Condom, and seven, Alain Kamenati. Heading for Kamenati, who's a big man near the back. Ball leaves near the 22 and knocked on by the French. And so here we go, the first scrum of the game. Now, there's been a lot of talk about the scrums in the lead-up to this test. Let's just have a look at it. All Blacks holding well, but the referee, Fred Howard, wants it again. A couple of minutes into the test match, no score. Magnificent day at Eden Park. All Blacks going ahead. Now the French starting to push it. Swirled around. Loose there for Deans. French have it. Just 20 metres short of the line. Comes out to Devergy. Good start here by the French. All Blacks have it though. Buckshelf at the skipper. And a penalty. And the referee indicated the boot was up in there. And the referee, Fred Howard, quick to stop any nonsense. And a penalty goes first up to the French, and very much in a kicking position for Serge Blanco.
Well, you can obviously see that the roughness in the last couple of games has obviously had an effect on Fred Howard. He was interested there to stop the rubbish right at the start. It always happens in tests. That's why you can't afford to play the first 10 minutes in your own 25.
Key part of the game here could be the goal kicking. The French have replaced Philippe Béraud, who missed those vital kicks in the first test. They're bringing in the man playing his 70th international, Serge Blanco, today. So here is Blanco. He has quite a good reputation as a goal kicker, but only once was he France's regular goal kicker throughout a whole season. That was way back in 1983. So the French want to get away to a good start. Blanco here needs to put this and turn it through the post and turn it into points.
Blanco is on target, and France lead by 3-0 after 3 minutes play.
Was it my imagination, or did he wait a long, long time till he was ready to get that one right?
I thought he was praying. Ferruzzo has made a big comment that he says it's so sad that normally France goes into most test matches and normally concede at least four or five goal kicks.
The All Blacks haven't been in the French half yet in the game. And it's not often the All Blacks are hit early. They're down by 3-0. Grant Fox with the restart. Ball just holding up in the light breeze. It was tapped by number 7, Kamenati. The All Blacks, though, have it near the 10-metre line in French territory. Here's the skipper, Shelford, up to Michael Jones, who slipped as he went to take the ball. Coming again now for Deans. Here's Fox. The inevitable first-up kick, and that's a good one from Fox. Schuster coming through. Ball still loose. Devergy has it for France. All Blacks piling in. And they'll take it back for a 5 metre scrum. But what a kick from Grant Fox.
It was a beautiful kick from Fox. But I still feel that New Zealand forwards haven't settled yet. They're quite loose, running into rucks. Ones and twos they're going into.
Referee wants to settle the scrum 5 metres out. All Blacks are split, the backs are split. Three to the right, three to the left. Controlled by Shelford, Bavizier in after it. Shelford now hands it up to Alan Whitten. Coming rather slowly for Deans. There it is now. Gallagher. John Gallagher. Just a metre short of the line. And once again, the whistle goes.
Well, it was interesting then too. Fred Howard was very quickly jumped in to stop that ruck, or one might even call it a maul. He's worried about the play and worried about people getting hurt, obviously.
Fred Howard in amongst the New Zealand team huddle. One of the Frenchmen is down here. Pulsating beginning to this game. It's really nerve tingling, isn't it? French doctor coming screaming across the field at the moment. Is this just Garraway, is it? No.
Yes, it was Garraway.
So right on the line, the All Blacks going for the pushover. French holding. Shelford very close to the line. Once again, the All Blacks can't get across. Uh-oh, bit of trouble perhaps. No. Richard Lowen there.
But the point of it all was, it was a far better New Zealand scrum.
Third scrum in a row, close to the French line. 5 minutes gone on the test, and down they went. They collapsed the scrum, and the All Blacks have a penalty. Let's have another look at the scrum. And the All Blacks have obviously got it together in the last couple of weeks. The French are deemed to have collapsed that scrum. And so the All Blacks get the penalty. Here's Grant Fox lining it up from a handy position.
Well, I thought that Mr. Howard was very brave there to give a penalty for that. I think they almost slipped as they tried to bore in. I don't know that they're really worth 3 points. That's basically the whole thing. They're controversial. And he's a back. And I don't think unless you've played up there, you know too many of the ins and outs of the front row club rules. Was the inevitable Fox penalty. The French forwards, though, I feel are very controlled. He's been instilling discipline into them in the last week, and I think that they're probably the most controlled that I've seen them in any game in my lifetime.
So Philippe Rouget-Thomas kicks out, number 10 kicks to number 10, and Fox bangs it hard that time. That's a good little kick, but it hasn't found the line. Curled around in the breeze. Blanco is going back to the safety area. And he's hit it hard. He knows he's got the wind behind him. And look at that for fullback Serge Blanco today, as you've heard, beating the record. No other players played 70 for one country.
6479.
Take it. Come here. So here's Sean Fitzpatrick, Sandy McNeil, the touch judge from Australia in the background. Musty palm by Murray Pearce. This is Schuster. Oh, a little variation into space. A little pop by Schuster. That's Salah. Put by Schuster and Stanley. 10-meter mark in France territory. Verbizier. Blanco. Space to the left. Lajusquet. They're finding the footing. A little soft. Near halfway. And it was not releasing the ball in the tackle. Lajusquet is penalised. There was a bit of a chance there on the left with Bibizier, Blanco and Lajusquet to the left.
Yes, Blanco was endeavouring to run around Lajusquet, and that was to obviously set it up outside Kerwin. But he didn't quite get the way he went on the inside.
Did you like the little kick by Schuster, Earl?
Well, it was a deft little kick.
I suppose 99% of the players in New Zealand would have whacked a big wipers kick in, the big slide ruler that goes right across the field, but Schuster just a little pop kick. So Fox has put New Zealand up to this attacking position after 9 minutes in the first half. Jones and Carminati at the back. Taken by Mark Sessi on number six. Bebezier, narrow side. Elijah Stay. Deans blocked him and made the stop there. John Kerwin standing well back on the right wing side from that position.
27, 41.
2-7-4-1.
That's the voice of Wayne Shelford. This is Sean Fitzpatrick.
And off your screen, the New Zealand backs are very deep. They obviously expect to win the ball and move it.
That's McDowell and the tidy up on the 22. Back to Fox. Schuster left out. Stanley. Kerwin. Gallagher was up. Terry Wright on the left wing side. Gallagher backing up. Great run by Gallagher. Take it up, right by the corner flag. Serge Blanco in his 70th international met John Gallagher face to face, and what a good tackle it was. So New Zealand have a real chance here. They've shortened it up, the French. That was Condon. Denizier has the ball in his hands. Good kick by Blanco. So he already looks in good shape. He's kicked the goal. He caught the high ball. Made the good tackle. Serge Blanco of Biarritz Olympique. Three all, 12 minutes gone. A penalty to each of the team's kickers. That was lovely controlled play by the New Zealand team. And here comes another 3 points, I would say. Handy enough. This is simple stuff for Grant Fox. And it's a line-out infringement. What was that one for?
Well, I didn't see that. It was very sad. I just say how controlled they were. But at that stage, Salah came from the wrong side of the ruck and just plowed straight into the back of the All Black ruck. I mean, he had to be penalised.
You really have to ask, Earl, what the heck Salah was doing in that position. And he was way out of position, wasn't he?
Exactly. I mean, he was coming back. He'd come up, take it on the blind side, and he was running back into it. Very, very silly penalty, though.
Fox looking right into the sun after 13 minutes of play. That's New Zealand into the lead after 13 minutes of play. Two Fox penalties, and they're into the lead by 6 points to three. Fox going up to 233 points in international rugby. There's the lead for the New Zealand team in glorious conditions here at Eden Park in Auckland. Three penalty goals have been converted to points in the first 30 minutes. So it's New Zealand 6 and France 3.
So Buck Shelford urging the troops on, and the French are going to try a tricky little kick here, but they've kicked it straight to Joe Stanley, who knocked it on. As he looked into the sun, the referee waiting for some advantage. There is none. And the last man up will be number 13, Joe Stanley. There he is. In his 20th consecutive test this afternoon. Starting with the baby All Blacks way back in 1986 against France.
First four scrums all won by the All Blacks.
French should win this one, though. It's their ball, but once again, the front rows are down. On this side of the scrum, as we look at it, it's Steve McDowell against Jean-Pierre Garraway, the two strong men of the respective sides. As Bevisier feeds, held by Rodriguez. Now the French start to make progress, although the All Blacks have managed to screw it a wee bit. There's Carminati. You can see him to the right of your screen. He was pushing Deans way off the ball. I don't think it was Carminati who was penalised in the finish. It was number six, Session. But Carminati there, the blonde-headed fellow, he was pushing Deans way off the ball. Grant Fox on his own 10-metre line. And the French are going to pay for these silly mistakes. Fox has just driven them back 40 metres.
Yes, they started off well. They're finding it difficult to control themselves after they go out 10 minutes. But they're trying everything. They're down to two-man lineouts, and they're kicking off the wrong way. They really are trying to get away from the strength of the All Blacks.
15 minutes gone on the test match. 6 points to three. Two penalty goals to Grant Fox. To the one kick by Serge Blanco for France. Murray Pierce has done well in the lineout. That's another one, although it wasn't thrown in straight. Some of the players haven't heard the whistle as yet. Murray Pierce is really leaving the ground this afternoon, Earl.
He's desperate to play well. The battle is really on this side between McDowell and Garraway. They're slipping their arms and they're actually losing their grips too from time to time as they squirm in. Both trying to ball, basically.
The Bizier for France. It's 10 metres out from the 22 in French territory. Rodriguez holds again. All Blacks have to stay bound. Still 10 metres out from the 22. And once again, a scrum will be set, but the All Blacks get the put in.
And the French had that ball, and the scrum went forward, even though it screwed slightly. And Rodriguez is finding it hard to advance because he's basically too high in body position at present.
Now Bruce Deans. And it's an untidy aspect of the game so far of the scrums. This is a better one from the All Blacks, held this time by Shelford. Back now to Deans, Fox. Schuster has missed out. Stanley up to Kerwin. We haven't seen much of him so far. John Kerwin near the 10-metre line of French territory. The All Blacks take it ahead just a couple of metres. Well, the tackling has been strong again on both teams. Yes. 27th test match for John Kerwin. No tries so far in the game. 6 points to three. The All Blacks ahead. Awful lot of time being wasted with collapsed scrum so far in the match. Deans waits again. Now to Fox. A long one to Stanley. Almost got past Andrea on that occasion. And again the whistle quickly blown by Fred Howard.
You notice from these scrums how the only loose forward really that the French have got at present is the number nine captain, De Bizier. He's running at Fox all day long. He's playing very much the flanker role, particularly from scrum. It's quite interesting, really.
Fred Howard lays down the law to the front rows and gets a better scrum this time. Victor came off Shelford's knee. It wasn't knocked on. The French are going to win it, it would seem. No, they're not. And things are untidy at the moment. A little bit of a misunderstanding between Deans and Shelford.
The game has become a whole series of scrums in this little part of the field here.
De Bizier takes it out. Rougie Tamar challenged by Deans and charged down. And the French getting a little untidy. The whistle's gone for a knock-on again.
Another scrum right here. everyone's a bit nervous still. We've had nearly a quarter of the game and they're still knocking it forward and acting very nervously.
The French reckon they can win it at scrum time. They don't think they ever win a game at scrum time. That's what it's all about. It's intense pressure on the scrum.
Now Deans up to Fox. Change of tactics. Fox hits it high into the air. Terry White getting there. Barrow has it. Right near the goal line, but not quite over it. All Blacks desperately after it, but they can't get it back and there'll be a scrum. Philippe Barrow did very well there. It was another very good kick from Grant Fox. There's pressure on the French scrum. It's French ball. Near the line try. Alan Wetton, I think it is. Quick thinking by the Auckland flanker. And the first try of the game to Alan Wetton. But it all stemmed from a scrum close to the line. Watch Alan Wetton. It's fair game once it's over the goal line. And he dived through. Fred Howard saw him around the side of the scrum, and it was a try.
No, I don't believe it was. From the end on camera, it would certainly say that it wasn't.
Let's have a look at this now. Let's see if it did get there. Well, I don't think it did. It's short of the line now.
Alan Wetton is offside.
Interesting that Serge Blanco was immediately asked the referee to look up at the big screen to have a look at the replay of the thing. Yeah. And he went to the back there. So this is a real aid to the players here in the 1980s.
So a controversial try awarded to the All Blacks. Grant Fox attempting to convert and does so. So 12 points to 3. And I'm sure they'll talk about that try for years. Was it over the line was the first question. Was he offside? That's the second.
Well, it certainly wasn't over the line, and therefore Alan Wetton had to be offside because he'd left his binding position in the scrum before the ball was past the hindmost foot. Definitely not there, and he's offside because it hasn't gone over.
Roger Thomas kicks out. It's 12 points to 3 to the All Blacks after that controversial try. It's in the history books now. And there's an intercept! And away goes Roger Thomas! And the French have struck back!
Well, one might almost say that's poetic justice.
Yes, indeed. He did it in the first test. This man, Roger Thomas, a real game breaker. He breaks the game open with an intercept and a 40-metre gallop. Look at this. Lobbed it up and Ruse Tamar began a sprint, all perfectly fair, and away he went. He's not the fastest man in world rugby, you can see that, but he had enough steam up and a glorious dive in, and that's a sensational try for Ruse Tamar.
Well, Bruce Dean simply didn't look and he handed it up and Ruse Tamar took it away, and the French are back in it with that try by Philippe Ruse Tamar in just his second test match.
That's his opening try in his test career. He's a new man, remember, just coming into the French team, the main French team for this tour. And he opened it up with a little dummy at Christchurch, remember, and now a sensational try at the second test at Eden Park. Serge Blanco. Down the front, 12 points to 7 after 24 minutes in the first half. Bill Curtin.
I know it was. I think that was almost fair game. It was Deans took just a little while to clear it off the deck, and that was the difference. It allowed him to make some yardage.
So Grant Fox to restart now. France striking back immediately. 12 points to 7. Gary Wetton gets there quickly for the All Blacks. Looked to be knocked on by Buwe, but the All Blacks have it anyway, through Deans. Good run from Bruce Deans. Head-high tackle put on him. Wasn't spotted by the referee. Deans is back in position, feeds it up to Fox. Now Schuster. Here's Gallagher. Looking for and finding Jones. Michael Jones against Blanco. Stanley, try. Joe Stanley, and the tries are all coming at once.
Three tries in 3 minutes, what a game it's turned into.
Well, this was brilliant work by Michael Jones. The All Blacks spun it through the back line, and somehow or other the All Black number seven got out there. Here's Gallagher taking it up, and Jones is there linking up, and he went for a gallop. He took on Serge Blanco. He went in and out. Blanco hung on, but Stanley was in good support, and the veteran got there.
Oh, that was good football. It was typical New Zealand football, with a bit of flair in the back line and a tremendous run by Jones. But it just started straight from the kickoff. It was a lovely sequence. The score from a kickoff is most unusual. Good football.
There he is, Joe Stanley, his fourth try in Test matches. The Ponsonby Express, Smoke and Joe, call him what you will. That was a lovely work by him to go in for his fourth try in Test matches. The conversion now to come from Grant Fox.
Fox didn't like it, he put his head down. That normally indicates it's not a goal. And so 16 points to 7 now, the All Blacks ahead.
Remember, Fox, that breaks a little sequence here. He got to 10 goals in a row, I think it was, last year here against Wales. Didn't miss one kick. And he's got his first three here. He loves this ground, obviously. So that's his first miss. So it's almost like you have to mark that down in the record book. So it's kicked down now to Grant Fox, and he'll reply from the kick out. New Zealand and France have been playing 26 minutes in the first half. 16-7. Kamenati takes it into setup. And we may see more points coming in this flood of points. Babizio wants a shot at goal after just a few minutes. Earl Curtin, those tries really broke the game up, didn't it? Was looking a bit all stereotyped and stodgy with all those scrums there for a while.
Right, I mean, they were having, it was a battle of one might call strength, and that's what they were particularly interested in, and that's what everyone's been talking about in the paper. And so it was obviously a battle.
This is Ron Williams warming up on the sideline. Might come into his first test match. Wonder what's happened to one of the New Zealand front row forwards. Ron Williams from North Harbour. Now the wind feels as though it's coming across the field and blowing down into that corner, so this might be quite a tricky kick for Blanco. He's kicking across the wind of it. 27 minutes gone. What a big kick! Oh, Winston McCarthy once said, goodness gracious me, it was twice as high as the posts. And that one was a huge kick from Blanco. 3 points, 16-10. And the points have been coming in a huge torrent there. That ball in the very high goalpost at Eden Park very nearly cleared the top of the post. So the French keep within striking distance. It's 16 points to 10. 10 minutes to go. Just over 10 minutes to go till the half-time break. And Serge Blanco keeping his country in this game.
Grant Fox again from halfway. Two tries to one the All Blacks lead. Tipped away by Jones. Fox gets it on quickly to Schuster. Opening up again here for the All Blacks. Just losing his footing again, John Schuster. It's a little slippery on the surface here at Eden Park. Here it is again on the blind side. Shelford. Lost forward by Shelford. Knocked ahead by Blanco. They'll play the first infringement, which was the mistake made by Buck Shelford.
You can see the New Zealand pattern starting to emerge now. Buck's trying to go wide and staying off scrums. But it's basically they're trying to run this heavy pack round.
Berbizier back to Blanco inside his 22. And it's been fascinating in the last few minutes. After quite a dull patch of about 10 minutes, already he's made his mark on this game. Serge Blanco.
Richard, call 47. 65.
4765. Alain Carminati towards the back of the line-out for the French. Done some good work in the line-out so far. All Blacks looking and getting it from Alan Whetton. Here's Steve McDowell. running it out towards the centre of the field. This will make a bigger blindside. They don't use the blindside though. Fox up to Schuster. Gallagher chiming in again. Good tackle put on him by Salah. 15 metres in French territory.
There was a beautiful tackle by Salah. He grabbed him and picked him up and drove him into the dirt. Pile driver.
About 10 minutes to go till halftime. Shelford hands it up to Deans. Got away from one tackle. Ran back towards the safety of the All Black pack. Controlled in there, and Steve McDowell drags them through. 2 metres out from the 22.
All Blacks just need to stay on their feet a bit more and bind so they don't start falling over. We need faster ball, basically, New Zealand does.
Another good attacking position here for the All Blacks. Shelf it up again to Deans. A little one for Kerwin to chase onto. Blanco read it well, though. The anticipation of the man is amazing.
But the New Zealand pressure is going on. They're starting to stretch it wide and really applying pressure now.
All Blacks doing well at line-out time. Coming rather awkwardly for Deans. He left it behind that time. And the All Blacks got themselves offside. They made no real effort to retire. And Pierre Bavizier now just calming things down a little for the French. Rougie Tamar. Remember, in the first half, the French have the advantage of what really is only a light breeze, but they do have the sun. Eight minutes to go in the first half.
So this is Sean Fitzpatrick. They've line out right on halfway. 16 points to New Zealand and 10 to the French. It's a tight, tough test match with an explosive period when we had 3 tries and a penalty in 5 minutes of play, including the controversial one for New Zealand, the lucky break that went to Alan Whetton and the New Zealand team. And that's the difference between the two teams. So it's an even contest here at the moment. All the scrums have been won on the loose head, 10-5. So that means New Zealand have had twice as many put-ins as the French. Rougie Tamar. Elijah Stay is going to pressurise Kerwin. That's Session. That's Marc-Andrieux. Here are the French going well. They're playing advantage. Bavizier finds Rougie Tamar. Lajesque trying to get the ball. This is Rougie Tamar again. Rodriguez has got it behind his back. Like a kind of a magician trying to keep it out of sight. That's the 22. Referee says play on. That's his signal from Fred Howard. And this is a penalty right out in front of the sticks.
Yes, he penalised Pierce for not rolling clear of the ball. He was just lying there and expecting the French to go over it. Here he goes down. Now Pierce is going down basically on the almost on the wrong side of the ruck. And he lies down alongside him, as you see here, and doesn't let the ball come back to the French.
Quite remarkable ball skills there by Laurent Rodriguez. He lost it behind him, but somehow hung on. A little bit like Michael Jones in that wonderful try he scored here at Eden Park a couple of years ago.
That's right. Back to the job in hand. The man crouching down in centre screen with the man who was penalised. Number 4, Murray Pierce, just 10 metres in front of him. Put your biggest man right on the 10-metre mark and see if he can put him off somehow. You can't charge a penalty, of course. In the background here, Serge Blanco. Time gone, 34 minutes. So Blanco has made no mistakes in his kicking so far. Well, he's hit 3 out of 4, and the gap closed up now to 16-13. And it's anybody's game at the moment, Earl Curtin.
I thought the New Zealand side were actually putting more pressure on, were starting to start and play well. and I feel that they'll continue to do it. I still think the French have still got to do it.
So Terry Devergy, Jean-Pierre Garraway, this incredible build. Pascal Ondart, also from down in Biarritz. Up goes Devergy, one of the discoveries of the tour for the French.
As you can see, the ball in there, he's never going to let it go, Devergy.
This is Test match rugby at its toughest and tightest. He's head for New Zealand. Deans away to Fox. Fox is going to put one onto Blanco again. Schuster coming through. Oh, their arrival time is the same. Near the line, loose ball. Oh, look at this. That was Lazarus Day trying to run the ball out. They haven't been looking at the videotapes from 1984, that's for sure. They conceded a try at the other end of the field from behind the goal line. And that's typical French unpredictability. To run it out from there is kind of crazy.
I think he had so much pace on, he couldn't get his leg up to kick it.
Patrice Lajusque, the speedster, once clocked for 10.6 seconds over the 100 metres. That's Olympic Games quality. Pierre Bizier in defence. Blanco bangs it high and hard. Good relief from Serge Blanco, the fullback. He's banged it 30 metres up the touchline. New Zealand are 16 and France are 13. The line outs are favouring New Zealand 5-3. The penalties are 4 each and the scrums are 11-7 in New Zealand. Just slightly getting the advantage from all those put-ins at the scrum time.
8-6-5-4-3.
Good work by Gary Wetton. Schuster left out. They're trying to get Kirwan into the game. One gets the impression they'd like to give the big fella a run, but he's been well marked so far. Roger Tamar was the tackler of Kirwan on that occasion. Okay, Ilkin, what do you think of the refereeing so far?
Well, I don't think he's letting Rucks and Moores go very long. He's obviously worried about injuries and the indiscretions that occur, obviously, at Ruck and Moore time. So I feel he's panicking slightly.
He's come a long way to be here, the referee this test series, Fred Howard. Half-time approaching, some 3 minutes away. Fox, Schuster, Johnny the Shoe hits the deck, towed away by Bibizier. Deans and Bibizier meet head-to-head. But he's a pretty tough character as the Glenmark player from North Canterbury, Bruce Deans, number 9. These are the two teams that fought out the first ever Rugby World Cup final in 1987 on this ground. Good jump by Pierce again. Untidy ball though. Watch the position there, Richard Lowe. He's standing right behind the French side of the pile-up. It's a relief for New Zealand now. And Fox will probably go for safety here along the touchline. So just 3 points the gap. And Fox has had two penalties and a conversion so far in the first half. 16 points to 10 as halftime approaches.
Once again, the French have cut down the numbers in the lineout. And my word, they're a tall side, a big forward pack. Michael Jones right at the back against Alain Caminati. You can see the difference in height there. Caminati goes up and stretches and gets it too. Here's Ondart, 5 metres in French territory. Walks over it well. Bevisier up to Roger Tamar. Gallagher to go across. Blanco is there. And John Gallagher did very well indeed. Kipper from the Oriental Rangatai Club in Wellington. What marvellous form he's in at the moment.
You should call that an athletic kick, really.
Is he here?
Once again, a shortened line-out here by the French, varying the tactics. The All Blacks ahead by 16-13. Caminati has done good line-out work today for the French. No sign of it in there, though.
What a good player Kamenati can be when he's concentrating on playing rugby. He's got a bit of a bad reputation, a bit of a bad boy reputation down the back of the line-out and in the back of the scrum. But he's a good player.
Remember the half-time score in Christchurch. It was 18 points to nil to the All Blacks. The French a lot closer here, 16 to 13. Bebizier up to Rougie Tamar. And back to Henrieux. Good support from Session. 5 metres on the All Black side of halfway. And the French have another chance here. Oh no, they changed it. Fred Houts changed it. He gave the penalty to the French. And they, I think, went in with the boot. And Fred Houts changed it immediately. Let's have a look.
I think Rougie Tamar indicated he went in to dig the ball out after the penalty was... After the penalty was ordered to try and hook the ball out. However, looking at that again, he...
I don't think it was stomping either. No. I think he was definitely going in to hook the ball away from those trapped legs.
So what this. Could have been a shot at goal for Serge Blanco has turned into a shot at goal for Grant Fox. Now, this is interesting. Fox is a couple of metres on the All Black side of halfway. He's kicking into what is a very light breeze. It's got to be at the extreme end of his range.
But I do think it's good tactics too, because he's going to punt it. It'll probably hang up in the wind too, so it'll end up being, or could be, a reasonable attacking move.
Half time is just around the corner. In fact, 40 minutes of playing time is up. Grant Fox from 53 metres. He'll get the distance, I think. Oh-ho! Hit the post. Kamenati. Rodriguez is taken by Terry Wright. Bebizier. Loose to Lajiske. And that is the end of the first 40 minutes of the test match. And at the break, the All Blacks lead by 16 to 13. We'll be back after this break.
Back live from Eden Park in Auckland, New Zealand, the second half of the second test between New Zealand's All Blacks and the Tricolours of France, and New Zealand leading by 16 to 13. Now, this is the part of the game, you remember, that the French played so brilliantly at Christchurch. Will we see a repeat today? Blanco has started with the kick out into over the touchline on the full, but it's this man and players like him, like Philippe Salah, Philippe Rouget-Thomas, who are the ones that could break the game open. The New Zealanders are playing it tight and steady, and we have to say that it's the French brilliance that could break this game open. Let's watch. Good work by Pierce. Fox, Schuster, trying to get Kerwin into the clear again. He has been closely marked. Midfield, outside the French 22. Richard Lowe trying to untangle himself from that ruck and pile up. And something was set by Richard Lowe, a penalty to New Zealand. Now they may try a shot at goal here. It's a big one. Fox, he'd be encouraged by the fact that Fox went so close. Richard Lowe standing there. Blanco speaking with referee Howard. There is an injured player behind. Well, what did you make of all that, Elkert?
Oh, well, I just think it was a pile-up and a ruck, and obviously the New Zealanders, as they're accustomed to, were trying to rake it back. And they've obviously, Fred Howard thought that they're probably being over-vigorous in what one might call a static ruck.
I don't think the French have indicated yet whether they're going to kick for goal. They may just tap it and run here as the game restarts. Could be interesting to watch what happens. It's Philippe Rouget-Thomas from the Toulouse club. Blanco, I don't think, has indicated. Yes, he has. It's going to be a shot at goal. Now, this is a huge kick. This is longer than the one by Grant Fox. But this man inside possesses the kind of brilliance and inspiration that could land a goal from back there. And believe me, the French have had some huge goal kickers over the years. I remember Pierre Villepreux at Wellington. I think he might have been playing that day, Earl.
Yes, he kicked a massive one in the second half. I thought, heavens, I thought it would never cease the way they played. It was a brilliant kick.
Staggering kick by Serge Blanco, and it's 16 all now. Just a couple of minutes into the second half, and here go the All Blacks. They desperately want this one. It's coming rather slowly. There it is now. Fox again, the kick. Was hit a bit late by Rodriguez. Taken in by Andrieux, and the late tackle has been spotted by Fred Howard. He had to wait to see where the ball landed. Fox was taken late by Rodriguez. Let's have a look at this. Fox positions himself for the high kick. A bit like Simon Poitevin's charge last year when Steve McDowell scored the try. Bang. Rodriguez definitely late. And now a chance for the All Blacks to hit back.
Yes, he was late. He wasn't very late, as they say. He was trying to arrive early.
Trying to arrive early, but he got there late. Okay, Earl, thank you very much for that. Well, Grant Fox doesn't miss many on Eden Park, so we'll see how he goes here. 16-all, once again, as at Christchurch, the French struck back early in the second half to close the gap on the lead that New Zealand had at the break.
Established their three-point lead, 19 points to 16, the penalty goal by number 10, Grant Fox.
Well, let's hope the penalty goals don't settle this test. It'd be lovely to see both sides move it.
Harry Pearce has been doing pretty well in the line-out count. The line-outs at the moment favouring New Zealand by 7-3. Only three cleanly won line-out balls by the French jumpers in the first 40 minutes.
Yes, and that's where the French are losing their way, really. And that's why they're reverting to shortened lineouts.
Philippe Rouget-Tomar kicks out with New Zealand back in front by three. Bangs it straight to Fox. Now, Fox knows he's got the wind behind him, but he hasn't found touch, and that's the third time in the game he hasn't found touch. Let's see what the French do. The All Blacks have moved up quickly. Blanco hoists it high. And his, for the second time, goes out on the ball. So the touch kickers, Fox and Blanco, have made their mistakes today. But the big questions are now, can the New Zealand defenders stop those French backs? Can the French get line-out ball to run as they did so brilliantly at Christchurch? And we haven't seen them so far do that in this test match. Intensely absorbing test rugby. The All Black pack driving forward. The big black blanket. And they've won the right to the put in. This is a good position here. Blindside Earl Curtin, or was it too close to the touchline?
No, too close to the touchline here. But it's rather sad when you drive as well as that and you still can't free the ball.
A little short one this time. Schuster going through. Andre has gone up high. Deans swinging it to the left. Gallagher's looking good here. Gallagher came hairing up from fullback. And if they could only have got it to him, he might have been in at the corner.
Yes, it was just a slightly delayed pass. It's a very delicate pass, that. You must draw the man. And Wright just failed to do that.
Defensive line out for the French.
Take the throw, take the line.
Yes, it was a knock on, and you heard referee Fred Howe there would say, take the line out. Which is a bit of a good fortune for New Zealand, too, seeing they're so far ahead in the line out counts. 9-2, and clearly one ball. Another untidy ball. Olivier and Fitzpatrick in some sort of dispute there as to who is going to hold the ball. Gary Whitten, big jump, not forward though. There's one of the most famous profiles in New Zealand rugby, Griswiley in mid-screen, the All Black coach. This is a vital part of the game, the early moments of the second half. It's going to be a penalty for New Zealand, but they may go with Blanco's kick. Yes, indeed, advantage played by the referee. We've had 8 minutes in the second half, and New Zealand are leading the French by 19-16 with just a penalty to Fox and a penalty to Blanco since the halftime break.
So Sean Fitzpatrick now to throw to this lineout. The All Blacks have had the better of the lineouts, no question about that. Number four, Murray Pearce, has been a magnificent form. Alan Whetton stretching high there. All Blacks have had them all going better in the second half. They're rolling this one, or trying to. French holding, though. Now the All Blacks make a bit of progress. This time they can deliver it. Fox again, the kick. Remember the French looking into the sun in the second half. Ball loose. Terry Wright tries to claim it. And the ball did emerge finally, but the referee's whistle went. So two tries to one so far in the game. Alan Whetton with that controversial try for New Zealand. Then Joe Stanley and Ruge Tamar scored the try for France. Yeah, that was a good attacking opportunity for the All Blacks. But once again, the scrum's gone down. And Earl Curtin, this really has been an annoying facet of the game.
Oh, yes, and the rucks being in the size of two has been.
Buck Shelford goes away, quickly taken to the ground, though. All Blacks do well to win it. Now Fox. Schuster. Gallagher, at least Kerwin's in. Gallagher. John Schuster. Here's Blanco. He was taken down after the kick was made. Kerwin goes back. And yes, it was spotted too by Fred Howard. The tackle was made by John Gallagher after the kick was made. And thus it was a late tackle.
Well, my heart jumped there. I thought Blanco was going to be in under the post. There was no one ahead of him, but he elected to kick. And Gallagher took him down. And Blanco's going to have another shot at goal. This is D.B. Clark country. He's back in here.
Yes, I think Kipper thought twice and then decided on the professional foul. See it here again. He had no compunction. Kipper Gallagher definitely knew that it was that or death. As you see there. Yes, soccer man will enjoy that.
Well, this kick is a real toughie. This one is on a wider angle. Not this time. He's short. And Grant Fox has all the time in the world from inside his 22. And that's a good kick from Fox. Well, it's all about timing, and Serge Blanco didn't have it on that occasion. But his contribution so far, 4 penalty goals to the French, 16 points. The All Blacks ahead, though, by 3.
The Bizier throws to the back. Kamenati, who's been the best of the French lineout men, deflecting it down. Called a knock forward by the New Zealand jumper, who's jumping just in front of Kamenati. A midfield position at halfway for the French. Let's have a look at their backs. There they are lining out behind. Blanco is up and wandering out towards the right. Rodriguez at halfway. Over the top, Bibizier, Blanco. Lovely kick. Oh, Biro fell down, and that was out of your screen. You saw a classic Hollywood. What's the French equivalent of Hollywood? The Cannes Film Festival or something, because Biro did a lovely dive, all on his own, rolled along in the grass and got up rather embarrassedly, ran back. It was an attempt to get a penalty, but naughty. But the French are on hot attack here, and it's a vital throw in here for them by their captain, Pierre Bibizier. You see Dominic Bouet here, number two, is the dummy halfback, standing away to the right. Michael Jones lost it near the line. A try for the French. They've got the lead. Marc Cessillon's done it again, as he did in Christchurch. The big flanker Marc Cessillon has scored. Look at that. The French have got the lead. We're going to have a titanic last 30 minutes here. It came from the throw-in, deep to the back. Michael Jones fumbled it. It bounced off his chest. There might have been a problem with the sunlight. Watch the bouncing ball. Cession picks it up, lunges for the line, and the try is scored.
Well, Michael Jones was definitely unsighted here. Watch, he doesn't really see the ball coming at him, and it hits him on the face, I think. It bounces loose, and it was anybody's ball, and Cession was first there, and he reached underneath, and that's the second try for France, and they're ahead.
Well, 20-19, there's the work of the French, missing a kick in that handy place. That'll be a vital one.
Well, that's Farou. Farou says he picks his 15 players first and his goal kicker second. I think at test level, you've got to pick a goal kicker.
A try in each test for Marc Cession. The French have the lead. The crowd are roaring. 10 minutes gone, second half.
Grant Fox, the restart from halfway. The All Blacks aren't often behind in test matches, but they are at the moment. Bibizier reaches in. This will come to Terry Wright on his own 10-metre line. Big kick down inside the 22. Rouge Tamar. And that's just as big a kick back. None of these kicks are finding touch. Now Bruce Deans takes it up. Running it hard. Cession underneath it. Deans did well. 10 metres up from the 22. McDowell at halfback. Now Jones. Can the All Blacks turn this one into points? Near the 22. Deans again, Jones, up to Fox. The All Blacks have numbers here. Schuster, Gallagher. French defending valiantly. All Blacks didn't have a halfback, but Cession is offside. Well, frenetic stuff from the All Blacks. And what a good passage of play there from Bruce Deans. But Marc Cession, who just a couple of minutes ago scored a try, has been penalised, and Grant Fox has a chance.
Well, I thought that Howard was very hard on Cession there. The ball was actually free from the ruck. If you watch here, you'll find that the ball spews free from this ruck when John Gallagher goes down.
I agree with you, Earl. It was an open country in
yes,
that
it was. Yes, it was. And therefore entitled to come in and pick that ball up.
I think the French have been a bit hard done by the referee in this game so far.
Here he comes in there. He's coming in now. And it's loose there, and I think he was entitled to pick it up where he did.
That's perhaps not the best angle. We may see it better from another view. This is the high ball over the top to Gallagher. The French defence was across here. High, hard tackle by Sarah. Now look for Cession, number six. Was the ball in the clear when he went to grab for it? No, I think it was.
Yes, it was definitely out of the ruck.
But the bottom line is that the penalty is to be taken here by Grant Fox. No, it's going left. And goodness me, Terry Wright was there quickly. Says Blanco didn't like it. But it was fair play from Terry Wright. Now, here's Marc Session leaving the field. So that's a big blow to the French fortunes in the game. The man who's just scored a try, Marc Session, is off the field. And the French are down to 14 men. The man about to come on is Olivier Roumat. So that will actually add height to the French line-out. Session off, Roumat on.
Yes, that's a big blow for the French. He's their best loose forward.
Now, did the kick go over the 22? Referee Howard says that it didn't. So the All Blacks now have a good chance of going left to right.
You see on the wide view here, they've split the right, they've split it from the scrum. The Fox has done the right thing. He's taken Stanley to the left to leave the right-hand side open. As we all know, it's a lot easier to pass the ball probably to the right from scrums, because you're running with the flow of the ball.
Certainly very attacking, Earl Curtin.
Yes, I'll bet you they come right.
They're coming right. Deans. Oh, dear. Gallagher, loose ball. Shelford snaffled up the down Rodriguez as well. All of it slow and without bubbles that time.
Nadine should have just let those two outside go, Gallagher and Kerwin, run. They should have had a clear poke at the line.
Yeah, they're the runners, aren't they?
Exactly.
22 metres line, France in the lead. Blocker skied this one to Gallagher. Hard one to catch and he's caught it. Gary Whitten taking that down. It's going to come for New Zealand. Fox. High. Blocker waiting. Stanley charging. Shelford. Desperate defence. That's the goal line right there. Penalty for the All Blacks.
Well, that was a fair call again by Fred Howard. Salah definitely went in again from the wrong side after he came back to try and help Blanco out. Salah dived into that ruck from the wrong side and tried to lock it in. You see him here, number 13, and he goes down, look, and then he goes in down here on this side to stop it coming back to New Zealand, in there.
Yeah, good call, Earl. That was it, all right. Salah gave away a penalty. I actually thought he might have given away a penalty because he seemed to be stopping the New Zealand charging backs coming through when Blanco was waiting under the ball. So perhaps justice was done a little further on.
He did both.
Well, I won't get 6 points because they only penalised him once. But Fox, a handier position here. The wind, remember, is blowing more or less from Fox's right elbow, if you like, through to his left elbow. It's on that angle across the field. Twenty minutes gone, second half.
Off your screen.
All Blacks back in the lead now.
Off your screen, underneath the post, with Fox is taking his kick. The French forwards turn around and showed their backs to Fox.
Fox adds the penalty goal. You see the scoreboard here at Eden Park is not working. It's all in jumbled lettering. So there's no way the crowd here know how long to go unless they're keeping a little watch on their own. We can tell you, 20 minutes are gone now in the second half. New Zealand have got back to the lead. There's the sad sight of the French try scorer, Marc Session. He's off the field. They've replaced him with Olivier Roumat. And the French now go back to try and get the lead again. Three quarters of the game gone. Here's Grant Nisbet.
Here's Philippe Rizoutamar to restart for the French. Oh, I think he's kicked it too far. He has. Goodness gracious me. So back to halfway we go. That's a silly mistake to make. And the All Blacks now have the opportunity to open it up from halfway. Philippe Rizoutamar scored a sensational try in the first half of this game. But that's a poor mistake.
Yes, it's interesting. No, Grant, just before the scrum, the Blanco organised the defence on the right-hand side of the scrum.
Here's the All Blacks. Deans. Gallagher hits it hard. Can he run Kerwin in? Gallagher. Popped up for Alan Whetton. Michael Jones is there. The All Blacks have a chance. Deans. Well, he said no. I thought he made it. Bruce Deans it was. The crowd doesn't like it at all. We might see it on replay. Great run by John Gallagher, but I tell you what, I don't think John Kirwan could keep up. Bruce Deans to feed the scrum. The All Blacks right there. Still holding. Alan Wetton's bending down for it. Caminati was right there with him. There he is, Alan Caminati. Well, we might have to wait a wee while to show you that replay, because we'll have to stick with the live action here.
So I thought Deans definitely made it, but to be fair to Fred Howe, he had to run around, he was upside, he was on the other side of that run. And by the time he actually sighted it, they lifted him back over the line.
So the All Blacks try again. Another big scrum. Now Deans. That's justice. Bruce Deans got it after all. And the All Blacks score again. Well, I reckon he scored a try about a minute ago. But the little fella from Canterbury put it behind him. And let's have a look at who's he scores here. Confronted by Ruzi Tamar. He had a bit of work to do, but he stretched out, and yes, he got it down okay.
Well, he's the smallest guy on the All Black team, Bruce Deans, but my word, he's a tough character. A farmer from up in North Canterbury there, Glenmark, same club as Alex Wiley, and he wrenched his way through the French defenders to get the try.
Two instances, I think, of poetic justice today. One with the intercept try, and then with Bruce Deans scoring his second one.
Let's just go back a minute and have a look and see whether we think Bruce Deans did actually make it a little earlier. Here's the ball bouncing loose, and Bruce Deans goes after it here. Have a look at the line, and he stretches. Oh, he must have scored a try there, surely.
Yes, I think so. I think the point that Earl Curtin made was the good one. The referee was coming around and was unsighted by players. He can't award the try unless he sees the thing, you know.
But I did notice on that replay that did he actually get the ball to ground? He might have just been rolled as it hit.
So Grant Fox is after the extra 2 points here. And he's done it too. ...28 points to 20. Let's have another look at the near miss.
Well, here he comes round, but as they get under him, they actually try to roll him up. Now, I don't think, as yet, he's got it down. Yes, he did there. Sorry, he did too. Definitely got it down.
So, poetic justice. The All Blacks get the six-pointer. They're now in the lead by 26 to 20. 28 to 20. They're outside the six-point gap. Deans, a high ball. Rouge Tamar. Penalty to New Zealand. Just when the French were maybe getting a running chance. Four penalties, two conversions for Grant Fox, 16 points. There's this very fine trophy put up by the sponsors in the Steinlager series. And big gold silver. And that's the trophy for the winning team in the series. New Zealand looking like they might get it after they lost the lead there just after halftime. But what debates there'll be at the end of this test match. I make it about 26 minutes gone second half, but there's no clock in the ground that's going. The big electronic scoreboard, as I said before, is out. And so the fans here don't really know how much time there is to go. I imagine this is like it was in the old days, the good old days, Earl. The turn of the century when you were playing.
Yes, exactly. That's what happens with computers, the computer age.
One go waiting. Five meters out. Joe Stanley in there adding his weight. Loose head for the All Blacks. Smoking Joe was in there trying to add his weight. plays his rugby with all the vigour of a loose forward. Okay, Earl Curtin, there's a blind side here, isn't there?
Yes, I think, but it's well tied up with three men on the blind, three French defenders actually, out of your picture on the blind side at present.
Shuffled away to Deans, to Kerwin. Got his hands up for it. John Kerwin under all this. Okay, Curtin, a lot of talk about it. What do you think of him today so far?
No, I think he looks a lot sharper than that. I mean, he just hasn't had the chances, really.
Do you agree with Grant and Nisbet, who said before he couldn't keep up with Gallagher?
Well, yes, but Gallagher had a fair start on him, and the Frenchman was keeping him out too, which is a good play on their part. So he had to run round the Frenchman to actually get into a position to take the pass from Gallagher, and that was very difficult.
So there he is, big JK. Murray Pearce. Is he going to leave the field? Something happened to his nose, his face, his jaw, perhaps. Wellington locked forward, just going to the side of their field. So they want Murray Pearce on for the scrum. No medical attention for these men, the unsmiling Giants. You'll take the pain when you're at the All Blacks. They want this vital scrum. You get in there and push. And maybe sometime later you can see if you're okay. It's a very good position for New Zealand. It's slightly closer to the touchline, so the probably have to run it to the open side if they've got anything cooked up in the backs. I make it 28 minutes gone, second half. 28 to 20. Deans, away to Fox, there's a gap. Alan Whitten, forward pass. So many aspects of this game are going to be discussed and debated. Alex Wiley has been down to see to issue some instructions on the sideline. Bibizier. This could be where the French are at their most dangerous. Blanco kicking to the open side. Philippe Béraud's hardly been in the test match. Through on right. And that was good pressure by the right winger Philippe Béraud. Zinzan Brook warming up in the test match, which has 10 minutes to run. New Zealand are leading by 28 points to 20.
So the French once again call a shortened lineout. Murray Pearce still on the field for the All Blacks. Olivier Roumart, number 18, is a replacement on the French side, though. Here's Deans. Up to Fox. Here comes the kick again. Blanco across. Oh, he kept it in the field of play. Now Kerwin wants this one quickly. But it's been called a knock-on by referee Fred Howard, so it's not a line-out at all, it's a scrum. Now Murray Pearce has just decided to soldier on here.
Come on.
28 points to 20.
Stanley off your screen has come to second 5-8, which means he must be going to have a bash.
Here's the pressure kick again. Berbizier waits. Oh, he took it well, the little captain. Handed it back, though. Now it's loose. All Blacks getting their numbers. They'll drive it over the line here. Everybody's in. Oh, dear me. It's all on. Well, the pictures speak for themselves. And hopefully they've cleared the air a little. But Fred Howard has gone way out on his own here. He's run away 20 metres. And I think he's going to call out certainly Berbizier and I'm sure Shelford.
I don't think he can send anyone up here. It was sort of one in, all in, wasn't it? As I saw it.
This is very much that. But one of the linesmen down here has got his flag out, so he's obviously decided who the culprit is. How I can see from there is beyond me.
So now the law is laid down to Buck Shelford and Pierre Berbizier. Fred Howard speaks a smattering of French, so Berbizier will understand. Meantime, a Frenchman is down. Could be Rodriguez, I think. Laurent Rodriguez.
The touch judge still has the flag out, so he's going to have to make a report to the referee. So that part of it's over. Now, Fred Howard will go across and talk to the line umpire, Sandy McNeil. So let's go back and have a look at it. And it really was just an almighty blow-up. It was a big maul near the line. Let's see if we can see where the first one comes from. Oh, there's a big swing by Joe Stanley. It was Rodriguez on Stanley, and then it was all on. And Joe Stanley is absolutely incensed with what happened. Now, Fred Howard has had his little chat, and nothing has come of it, so you go back to the scrum right on the French line. Bruce Deans. All Blacks pushing. Oh, big shot from the French. Oh, suddenly the French just went woof, and the All Blacks scrum went back. About 7 minutes left in the game. This is an offensive scrum for France.
Coming back!
Once again, the front row is starting to get a little testy. Pascal Ondart and Richard Lowe on this side. Fred Howe's just trying to settle things down a little. Sean Fitzpatrick now is injured. So it's all come to a bit of a grinding halt here.
Oh, well, I think it's still all the aftermath. They're all a bit uptight over that last blow.
There's the scoreline with just minutes remaining. Packed house at Eden Park today. Glorious weather conditions and a dramatic test match as this 1989 series between New Zealand and France comes to its conclusion. New Zealand took the first test by 25-17. Here they lead by 28-20. But anything could happen yet. About 7 minutes to go. Defensive scrum for the French. Blanco was in right in close to see him there. Right back to Roger Thomas for the kick. And a good clearance, so the pressure relieved for the French 15 after that. Look at Murray Pearce. So Pearce playing on with a lot of clarity about it. There's a big gap. Look at that cut on the side of his face. That's a horrendous wound there. But Whitten has taken the ball for that hard drive. That's the 22-meter line. Deans. Fox gets the kick away. Blanco waiting. Schuster and Blanco. Drop out from the 22. The All Blacks will get back. French may try something here. They've got to break the game open. They want to win this. Roger Thomas kicks just a little chip. Taken in by Pearce, who's playing on bravely. Fox. Kerwin. Outside the 22. Fox. They've got numbers. It's 4-on-2. Gallagher. Right. Good defence by Perrault. Fitzpatrick. A try for Sean Fitzpatrick. That'll be the ball game. Hands reached down to pull the try scorer to his feet. But he's going to be slow getting up to this one. Let's look at it again. It came from the dropout. Then the All Blacks seem to win the ball and they seem to have the right sort of numbers out to the left. Kerwin tried to crash. It wasn't a good pass, but he got it well midfield. Then it comes to the left and you see suddenly it was 4-on-2. Barreau makes a good tackle when the ball gets out to Gallagher. Look at this. Good tackle here by Barreau. He didn't know what to do. It was actually on right. And here is some fast work by Sean Fitzpatrick. Must have been working really hard to get across here. And there he is, number two. Suddenly he finds just a one kick ahead and then flops on the ball. And I think it might have winded him.
Well, it was just all about pressure here from the All Blacks. They transferred it quickly across the back line. There was some good tackling here by the French. But the ball eventually came loose. And now it's here in the ruck. The French aren't terribly decisive here. The ball is just lying around. I think it is Gary Whetton who comes and makes a big tackle there. And it bounces clear for Sean Fitzpatrick. And down he goes on it. And that's a fair try.
Yes, half the French forwards actually stood still watching it.
That's 18 points today for Grant Box. 34-20. It's going to be a big scoring test match, as so many predicted. There's the try score, his third try in international, Sean Fitzpatrick. Have another look at it again, Earl Curtin.
Yes, well, it was really here where he was bowled by Gary Whetton. And, of course, they all sort of stopped. They didn't believe he could almost be onside, Fitzpatrick. But he certainly was.
Ruzi Tamar to restart. The All Blacks really can't be beaten from this point now. 34-20. They lead by 14, and there's about 4 minutes to go in the game. 18 points today again from this man. Remarkable average in Test rugby. Now he's got 245 points in Test rugby. This is only his 15th international. And there's Murray Pearce with that awful face wound. He's had a marvellous game again for the All Blacks. He was a big star in the first Test. Ball lying loose. Here's Rumart. Been a funny old game, Earl Curtin, hasn't it?
Oh, well, it's been untidy, basically. And even with that last New Zealand back movement, no one really drew their man, because Salah ran off and covered three guys.
Certainly has been a perfect performance by New Zealand by any means, but it's been a winning one, that's for sure.
Maybe it's all been told in the possession. 13 clean lineouts to 4 to New Zealand, 24 cleanly won scrums to 13.
So the French just haven't had enough ball, really. They've done well with what ball they have had. They've scored two tries. There's a line-out win through Rumart. This is the 10-metre line in French territory. As the shadows start to lengthen here at Eden Park, can we see some last magic from the French? Certainly not in this instance, we're not going to. This is centre field. Here's Bevisier. Carminati now, number 7. The tackling's been tough all day. This is Bouet, the hooker, having a run. Left it on the ground for Bevisier. Now the French might open it up from here. Lovely transfer to Barreau. Trying to get away from Gallagher. 10-metre line in All Black territory. The French still have possession, but they weren't able to free it. So 54 points scored in the Test match. John Gallagher now is... See that he's nursing that right arm of his as he made that tackle on Philippe Barreau. Haven't seen a lot of the attacking ability of John Gallagher in this game. That's the 10-metre line where the scrum is forming in the All Black territory. Bevisier to Ruzi Tamar. Across to Andrieux. Here's Lajeske. Tapping it back into the centre. This will be the 22-metre line coming down. Andrieux has it for France. Can the French produce a try in the last couple of minutes? Here's Carminati. Good tackle by Grant Fox. At least it was Bruce Deans. Now Bevisier. There's Lajeske. Blanco. French a little bit slow to get to Serge Blanco. Well, they're certainly trying, Earl Curtin. And in fact, that is it. All Blacks' arms go up. And the All Blacks have beaten the French here at Eden Park this afternoon by 34 points to 20. The All Blacks in the match scored four tries. Alan Whetton, Joe Stanley, Bruce Deans and Sean Fitzpatrick.
Right in, boys. Well done.